boycott baseball and all of the woke companies that are interfering with free and fair elections.
Get woke, go broke. Delta Airlines is learning the hard way.
But why are Delta Airlines and Coca-Cola getting involved in the details of a voter fraud bill?
What sport's going to be next? You know, what event's going to be next? What business is going to be next?
Trump and the GOP want to boycott companies. I thought they were against cancel culture.
Biggest threat is truly this
cancel culture, they call it. Cancel culture. No, thank you.
I'm not a believer in cancel culture.
Cancel culture, right?
Being censored on social media, they're living in fear of if these banks are going to cancel them, if these big corporations are going to cancel them. And I think that elected officials, Republican elected officials, are listening to voters.
Josh Hawley was all for canceling these companies years ago, and he and other Republicans are feeling the heat now that their corporate donors are getting involved. Where are we in American politics if even corporations feel threatened? And more importantly, should corporations even have this much power in the first place? Hey everyone, my name is Alyssa Bernardino. Thanks for being here. It almost feels like we're watching a little quarrel between best friends, corporations and Republicans. Republicans have moved so far beyond social norms that even corporations, entities our capitalist country views as so important that they can continue bribing our government with unfettered access to money, are feeling a bit vulnerable. For anyone applauding these corporations for taking a stand against racist restrictive voting laws, you might want to reconsider. History tells us it's a performative action, and they'll turn around and continue to fund the same people they condemn. Their concern is their profit margin, period. Melody Hobson, the chairwoman of the Starbucks Corporation, said that the controversies surrounding the new voting laws are bad for business. Hobson was so close, but she missed the mark by a hair. Because you know who it's actually bad for? People of color, especially black people. So trust me, Starbucks, you will be okay. If you're not, and you end up having to close one of the stores that you have on a block of 10 other Starbucks locations, well, that's just the invisible hand doing its job, right? It is mind-boggling, the absurdity of corporations saying, "We stand for democracy." No, you're standing in the way of democracy. Money in politics, funded by corporations and the billionaire class, is one of the main reasons we have so many issues with our democracy in the first place. We've legalized the ability of the super wealthy to pour unlimited amounts of money into campaigns, drowning out everyday people. So forgive me for thinking that this upheaval by businesses is tone-deaf and disingenuous. It's like members of Congress condemning people who commit crimes while simultaneously defunding programs that alleviate poverty and income inequality. So it looks like corporations are banking on the fact that as long as there is a degree of separation, some sort of intermediary between entity and bad thing, between lawmakers and crime, between corporation and the failures of our democracy, that their partners in government have defunded education so much as to blur the connection between the two. This unfettered injection of money into the veins of our government is cause for massive concern. That corporations are more influential than Democrats, other lawmakers, and more importantly, everyday people who are actually affected by and have been sounding the alarms on these kinds of restrictive voting laws is exactly the problem.